Anytime you out here in Colombia, you walk anywhere on the streets or to the beach or from your Airbnb, if you ever hear people honking the horn, those are gonna be two reasons. You're gonna either have the taxis or you're gonna have the people that do like taxi service on the mopeds. So the taxi service on the mopeds is a lot more cheaper too as well than the actual regular taxi. The only downfall to that is safety wise, because these guys are not wearing helmets when you're getting on. But they got a helmet on, but you don't have a helmet on. So if you fall and bust your head open or get like seriously hurt out here, I don't know how the medical service and providers work out here, but I know my insurance not covering that if I'm out the country, especially if I got hurt on some free time playing around. Like, you know what I'm saying? So that's the only risk you take. But when you get in a taxi, the taxi is gonna be a little bit more expensive. But if you ever hear the horns honking, boop, 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 you'll hear them beep, beep, or the mopeds and taxis, those basically letting you know that, hey, the taxi is available. So you need a ride, just all you gotta do is wave your hand. As I can see, here go the beach, right across from me. This is my Airbnb. My host has been nothing but phenomenal. As I told y'all earlier when I was up there, the stairs, I'm literally right across the street from the beach when you walk out the building. So you walk out the building, see, there go the horns, I heard it. You walk out the building and the beach is literally right there. Give y'all an example of what exactly I'm talking about. Listen, that's the moped. Hola. Y'all see what I'm talking about? Y'all hear the horn? Just watch. We're going to just keep it going for about like 30 seconds. See? Here come the taxi. Everybody's offering some type of service out here. Listen for you. See? There you go. So we just got on a tour bus on our way to the volcano. I just met some people from South Carolina. Cool people to be exact. But let me give y'all a view of the tour bus. A decent amount of people on this bus.
As y'all can see.
As y'all can see, we already started moving. And we're out to the volcano. So that was our tour guide giving us like some brief information, saying that we're gonna get there in 25 minutes. They also was letting us know about the service that they provide, that basically gonna charge. You would think that that service would not be charged, but they charge you for everything they do out here in Colombia. This is my friend.
Hello.
Tell them where you're from.
I'm from Ecuador.
Ecuador. How long you been in Colombia?
Five days.
You enjoying your time?
Tomorrow.
You enjoying your time?
Yeah, I really enjoy it.
Do you recommend people traveling to Ecuador?
Yeah, I recommend, yeah. Especially the Galapagos Islands.
Okay.
They are like a paradise.
Good, good. I'm gonna definitely put that on my travel list. That's his La Familia. La Familia. Hola. So yeah, I'm about to ask them about the services that they provide. Should be like about 10 or 15 minutes away. What services y'all providing that you were saying? I know you're giving information.
Yeah, iPhone services.
Yes.
The first service, the guy that take the picture with your phone. The second service, the guy that have your shoes. The third service, the guy that give you massage inside the mask. And the last service, the ladies that help you to keep the mask.
Do we gotta bring our shoes or we go with no shoes?
Yeah. Well, I say the service are voluntary.
No, I'm saying, could we leave our shoes here, or you recommend bringing shoes?
I recommend you, because all the area is rock.
The rock? Oh, okay. What about So if I want them to take video, they gotta pay them to take the video?
Yeah.
Can I take video myself?
If you want, but he's safer, give your phone to the guy.
I got like a stick, like a selfie stick.
Ah, okay.
That's cool. Okay, cool. Also, I got a drone. Can I fly the drone?
You have a drone?
Yeah.
Yeah, no problem.
Glass, yes. Thank you.
And for the rest?
Soup.
Soup?
I'll take soup. Okay, it's good soup?
Tell
the soup good?
Is it good, yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. So we have arrived at the volcano. It's about a 45-minute drive. So we finally arrived at the volcano, as y'all can see. My Ecuador friend. Gotta go throw certain things away. So I put a couple air tags in all my belongings. I got an air tag in my bag. Got an air tag attached to the drone, even though I got GPS. And I got an air tag in my wallet. These are the locals of the area. I'm barefooted out here. Don't mind the toes. So the steep, the steps to get up is a little bit steep. You can tell that basically is made from either concrete or the mud drying over time. I can't believe I'm really doing it. I just signed up to get into a volcano. Now that boy ain't going no steps. So as y'all remember from earlier, our tour guide David, he already explained to us, they charge you for everything. They charge you to hold your phone, they charge you to hold your sandals, they charge you to take pictures and videos. So I got this selfie stick off of TikTok shops, and it has been doing nothing but working numbers for me. So that basically cuts out that type of payment right there. That's an extra $3 for taxi or Uber, I could have saved. And it's $3 for each item that they charge you for. Each service, not item, my apologies. Each service they charge you for. So if you basically get your body rubbed on by the people that's in the volcano, that's $3. If you basically get your sandals hold, that's $3. If you basically had them record videos, it's $3. If they take a picture, it's $3. If they wash you off in the lake, it's $3. Not even sure how sanitary this lake is that you're finna be getting a bath in, but you only live once. I ain't got no open wounds or nothing, so I'm not really too much worried about it. We almost at the top. The sun is beaming today. It's hot. So on the other side of the volcano is a lake that we're supposed to get in. That's supposed to be where you like shower down and wash the mud off and take a bath. On the way up, you gotta get on these steps. Mind you, these steps is pretty steep. They probably like over, I'd say, a foot in height. And as you get closer and closer, the steps just continue to get steeper and steeper. We're about to get in the volcano. Call me Tarzan, the volcano. black Tarzan. But shout out to the real Tarzan, who's over there serving all the animals down in Miami, Florida, the world travel. You inspire people like me.
Everybody,
yeah,
go and get
us.
Get
a
job in
here. They ain't nothing getting a mug rubbed on me. That dude putting that stuff all in his hair.
You want a dog?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I ain't doing that shit. He tripping. I ain't putting it in my hair. Yeah.
That's all you gotta just keep your neck up. Oh, like
that's exactly what I'm about to do.
Yeah, but the tip I can walk right. But I was like, all that up? Yeah. Hurt. You get hurt. All the girls.
Remember while I was telling y'all about the passport girls? Check them out. They know how they are. Down there is the lake where they wash you off at. You gotta walk all the way from the field.
Ahora mismo.
You like it?
I have a sister down here. She's a Cartagena. Her name's Anna.
Okay.
And we came down here to come see her.
Oh, she's living in here?
Yeah, she's living
in here.
Oh, I pressed the video.
Go to my video and it goes to the top. You see
4K?
What
does
it say?
You need to cool down before you can use it.
Before I make a video.
Before you can use it.
Stop.
Yeah, I'm taking a video real quick.
Watch out, I'm taking a video.
Go put it in my ass.
Now I know how the girls feeling when they go to Jamaica. When they get no rap rubbed down.
You need to get rubbed down, though.
Yeah. No, I gotta say no homo. I live in Atlanta.
That happens.
I see how steep these goddamn steps is. Ain't no insurance out here in Colombia. You gonna bust your ass. Mind you, I'm 240. If you lean on these runners a little bit too much, this shit might go overboard. I'm in a goddamn volcano. Dude turned around like he was trying to ask me a question and smacked my ass with some mud. Can't trust him. I think I probably got mud in my head.
I'm not worried. I just asked where your
fan pass was. So we in Cartagena, Colombia. Just got out of the volcano. This is my South Carolina family.
Yes, sir.
The family.
Hello.
She's Jamaican. Just found that out. That's her sister in the back, right? That's her sister. Lamani. Oh, that's your best friend?
Okay.
Time to go get in this water. I'm not even sure if this shit's sanitary or not.
Probably not.
Yeah, it probably ain't. Cause this water look like it's just sitting. Ain't no moving water. I see vultures and falcons and shit.
Yeah, it's like a swamp.
Yeah. So if I come back with Mercy, y'all know where I got it from. That just gave me the opportunity to basically call out from work.
Amen.
Sarge, you seeing this? LT, you see this? Cap, Major, y'all see this?
That's what it's for.
Adelante, amores. This way.
Time to go wash all this stuff off. Body's giving. Now we on our way back to the bus, as I was telling y'all earlier. So what they do is, they have everybody stationed in one area before the buses leave. So they don't allow all the buses to leave at different times and you to walk back to the bus at different times. And then, so when you get there, so all the people that are doing all the rubbing down and all that, they try to beat you to the bus and stuff. So basically you can like pay them for the services. Look. Hell on your ass. They go to the volcano in the back. Still beautiful. I'm out here barefooted like I told y'all earlier. When I say my feet is burning, burning. I got slave feet, so it don't make me mad. So we just made it to our second destination. We're at the beach now. We're driving through their town.
Hola, mis amigos.
Hola.
¿Cómo fue el viaje? ¿Descansaron?
Sí.
Bueno,
me alegra.
Bueno, chicos, les comento, ya estamos llegando al hotel Coto Beach, como le dio mi
cuenta. So what it is basically you leave the volcano and you go to the beach, but the beach is like at a hotel resort. And the reason they did that because it's safer to do it like that than basically have people walking around and wandering on the beach in a town that we don't really know what's going on in. There's three different times you can depart. So we got the bus that leaves at 2 o'clock, you got a bus that leaves at 4 o'clock, and a bus that leaves at 5 o'clock. So you don't have to stay the whole day if you don't want to stay the whole day. You can easily just get on the bus at 2 and leave, or you get on the bus at 4 o'clock and leave. So depending on the type of vibes it is, it's gonna depend on how long I stay. You got a reason for that? They sell everything. Boy, it's just, no, I'm asking him. So I try to take a shower at the lake when we got out of the volcano. Ain't really do too good. They had a whole bunch of mud on me. And we in this beautiful hotel, almost like a villa. Feeling good now. I know a lot of these Colombians looking at me crazy right now. This man just took a whole bird bath in less than a minute. Yeah, damn right. Now that we just finally got done taking a shower, we give y'all a view of this. As y'all can see, they got an upstairs too as well. The top floor leading right out. It's a beach right out front. This is a hotel. See, I don't know a lick of Spanish, but luckily she's here. They came out with a side of rice and a salad. I said, I ain't want no salad. And they basically gave me a double scoop of rice. You know, fish is the number one thing I gotta see. Shout out to the South Carolina family. Mama. Hey, Instagram, Facebook family, shout out to my TikTok family too as well. I want to say thank you for all the happy birthday wishes. I'm happy to bring y'all along on my journey. Y'all can live through my lenses. I appreciate y'all. I appreciate all the love and support. Extremely overwhelmed with the love. I ain't know I was loved this much, but I just want to say thank you. This trip here has been nothing but soul searching, and I ain't gonna lie to you, it's probably one of the best trips I've been on. Traveling solo is not as bad as what people make it seem to be. It's a blessing to be out here. Today I actually hiked the whole volcano and I got inside the volcano. It's like a volcano where they had mud and stuff in it that's good for your skin. Right now I'm at another hotel where it's like a beachfront. I'm gonna give y'all some views and I'm gonna make a video for that so y'all can see y'all later on today. If you got any questions, hit me in the DMs, in the comments. I'm about to start posting more today. Well, I've just been on the go, so the Wi-Fi service is kind of bad out here. So hope y'all basically continue to enjoy. Love y'all. Hey, Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok families. Also my YouTube family. I'm here with
Erica.
Dan.
They from Georgia too as well.
Go Dogs.
Go Dogs. Here we go.
Are we repping the red?
Yeah. How y'all enjoying Colombia so far?
It's great. Love it.
Y'all love it?
Yeah.
What y'all do today?
Hopped in a volcano. Mud.
Yeah. Was it good?
Exfoliated.
Yeah, it was good. It felt so weird.
Yeah, got you. How's the food been?
Oh, awesome.
The food has been good. We thought the food wouldn't be good because they have a pretty low ranking on, there's like some food ranking.
Yeah.
Italy, Mexico, Japan.
To be honest with you, I think Colombia food is kind of better than Mexico. I went to Mexico not too long ago, last month, and the food here was kind of better to me.
Really?
How about the nightlife? How y'all like the nightlife?
It's weird. We haven't made it out yet.
What?
We haven't made it out yet.
Oh, y'all gotta come party with us tonight. I'm gonna go in town tonight.
Yeah,
we're going
that's
downtown.
Where we're staying.
Okay, good. Today's my birthday, so we're gonna
come. Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah,
yeah,
great birthday.
Yeah.
So, we toning out right now. I'm finna go outside and fly my drone so I get some more footage. But once again, shout out to
Erica.
Dan.
Go Dogs.
Go Dogs.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. Good evening, TikTok. Good evening, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. How y'all doing? I don't know where you at around the world, but wherever you at, I hope nothing but peace and love to you. So let's talk about today's adventure. Today we got the opportunity to go climb a volcano. Yes, a volcano. It ain't the actual volcano that we normally used to that we see in with fire, explosives, and gas. This volcano was actually a volcano that basically produces mud. There's no bottom to this. So literally, it's like one of those type of places where you go in the volcano, you climb all the way at the top, you get in the volcano, you take like a mud bath in the volcano, but you're literally floating. So you can't touch the bottom because there's no bottom, like I said before. After you get out the volcano, you basically walk, come down the volcano, and there's like a big, huge lake, like a body of water, where you got these young ladies out there that are washing you off the mud and everything off of your body. That's a charge. Y'all gonna see in the video that I'm about to post in a minute that everything that they're charging for. So after you do that, they give you a chance to basically explore the little town. Mind you, this is like an area where it's like it's almost like a village, I think, that we're in. So there's poverty there. So it's not like the place that we lose to, where you go to the hotels, you got the Airbnbs, you got like the city life and all that. This is like a village. So just think of the country, or, and just if you ever been to like Jamaica, or Puerto Rico or Thailand or anything like that. So think of like a poor area. That's basically where we at. But the volcano is right there. So normally, you got people that's out there cooking. They're selling all type of stuff, like items and everything, for people to buy, because the tourists that come out here are the people that got money to support their lifestyle that they're trying to live. I ain't got no problem with it. You know, that's kind of common when you're dealing with those type of circumstances. Luckily, we're blessed enough that we don't have to basically deal with that type of issue. But overall, the trip was fantastic. After we get done doing that, we got back on the bus. It was like another 30-minute ride to a place called Cocoa Beach that's out here in Colombia too as well. It's like a beach hotel. It's right there on the water. Of course, it's got a beach in it. And it got like a pool, food, everything, open bar, everything. Everything was fantastic. Me, since I've been here, I ain't been eating nothing but fish and coconut rice and the plantain. I ain't gonna lie, that's my number one dish that I'm gonna go to. I'm gonna go to it all the time, hands down. But the food is phenomenal. I'm not gonna lie to you. I've been to Mexico, I've been to many other Spanish countries like Mexico, I've been to Costa Rica, I've been to Puerto Rico. I've been around, so when it comes to Colombian food, I ain't gonna lie, Colombian food stands out to me. I'm loving it, I'm smashing it. As you can see, I ain't missing no meals. It's obvious, I ain't missing no meals. But other than that, man, the trip been nothing but great. After we leave that, the Liria is like another about, I'll say about another 15-minute ride back from the beach over to my Airbnb. I'm gonna show y'all. So Liria, the hotel that we came from, it's like literally right over there. If I can literally just point a straight line, that's exactly where it's at. It's literally on this side of the water, but further all the way down. That's basically where we was at just not too long ago. But that side is kind of different from this side. Like that beach is more of like a private beach. They got a lot more other things you can do. I seen people parasailing out there. They got surfing, jet skiing, all a little other type of boat, the water event that you could do. So it's a lot more for like people that's actually staying at that resort and to reap the benefits of it. but overall, great. Our tour guide, Dave, I think with Gold Pass, phenomenal. He speaks both languages fluently. So you ain't gonna have no problem with that if you don't know Spanish. I don't know that much Spanish at all. I know Patico, and I'm not even sure if I'm saying that right. I know no gracias, I know, and thank you. That's really about it. I don't know too much, so don't worry about it. You'll be perfectly fine. But other than that, man, great tour. If you get the opportunity to do it, do it. You will definitely enjoy it. Don't just come to Colombia for the obvious reasons why a lot of men come out here. And I'm beyond with you. Most guys come out here really for the women. There's more than that out here, literally. The people out here are beautiful. The culture is rich. And the food is phenomenal. So come out here and actually enjoy your trip and enjoy your time. You'll have a wonderful time. If you got any questions or anything, just write me, DM me. I'm free, and I'll get back with you as soon as possible. Peace and love. Out of here.